Hello everyone and welcome to another Tech and Music Ed video. My name is Chris Russell and I am the blogger at techandmusiced.com, and it's my pleasure today to bring you the JamStik Plus. The JamStik Plus is a new device that is the second generation of the original JamStik. And ultimately, if you look at these two devices from afar, as in this video, they don't look very different. In fact, they have the same exact body format. The only difference you might see are the brown pieces on the JamStik Plus right over here versus a black piece. And that is simply a wood overlay that goes on top that was included with this JamStik. Otherwise, from where you're looking, it isn't very different. There are two major differences from the original JamStik to the new JamStik. And the first one is that the new JamStik has a small pickup on the bottom, right here. And this JamStik, the JamStik Plus, is a Bluetooth device, whereas this one is a Wi-Fi device. Now, with this device, if you wanted to connect this one to the internet, which we'll do, what you do is, there's on the side here, there is a D-pad, and those D-pads have changed their function since the JamStik was originally introduced, not even a full year ago. But there's a D-pad, one button changes the octave, the other acts as a digital capo, and then there's a power button. On the other side, there is a little jack, and then there is a micro USB charger right there. So anyway, if I turn the JamStik on, the original JamStik, what that's going to do is to create a Wi-Fi hotspot with this device. So to connect to that, I need to take my iPad, and I need to go into the network, and in the network, so I have to leave the network that I'm on and find the JamStik when it appears. Now, what's interesting, so what'll happen is while the JamStik is booting up, you're not supposed to get in front of it because these are infrared sensors here. So you're supposed to kind of leave it alone while it boots up. And when it's ready to go, it'll glow yellow and it'll show up on my list. And with this original JamStik, it was named my JamStik and then a series of letters. And when I have a bunch of these at school, I write down the series of letters and put that on a label on the back so students know which one to connect to. But then I just simply select that JamStik and it becomes my Wi-Fi network. And then when I go into the JamStik Connect app, what it will do is it will show me, it just says there's a firmware update available. I'm gonna just connect for now, I'm not gonna upload. And my battery's a little bit low right now. In fact, that's why you can see it's glowing red and green. It's been a while since I've recharged this battery. But if I choose an instrument, such as the 12-string guitar, I can now play via Wi-Fi to the iPad. So, and then the button on the bottom of the JamStik is a mute that stops that from ringing. Now, once you're connected this way, you can use the JamStik with any core MIDI connected app. So this device is still very functional. It still has value. Again, there are some people that are upset because the original JamStik wasn't a full guitar, and they don't promise that it's a full guitar, and quite honestly, by looking at it, you know that it's not a full guitar. It basically fits into a backpack. But what you do get is you get the first 5 frets, real strings, and for anybody that's a beginner on guitar, or even a current player on guitar, generally, you don't need much more than those 5 strings to play a huge majority of chords. Now granted, if you're a rock guitarist and you want to do a full-out jam with the entire neck of the guitar, this is not going to be the device for you. But it is amazing how much you can do. So a beginner and learning from that is awesome. But also, if you're a guitar player and you don't play piano, you now have an option into music notation and other apps on the iPad or on the Mac, because this will also work with a Mac. I would show you that, but my personal Mac is too old, coming from 2008, to use the newer Bluetooth MIDI standards that are available from Apple. And again, once you're connected, you can choose all sorts of different sounds. So, for example, bass guitar. and so forth. So this again is JamStik Connect. They have an app called JamStik Tutor, works with it. And that was the original JamStik, and I've done a video about that in the past. So one of the problems is that when I have taught a guitar class, some of the guitar players that I get don't know how to read traditional music, but they do read tablature. And they actually go out on the web and they find tablature for the songs they want to learn how to play. And as long as they have a reference recording, they know what the tablature is supposed to sound like. Well, here's the deal. If you're connected to the internet on your iPad, you don't have the ability then to also pull up tablature on your device. You'd have to save it another way. So that becomes the challenge of the Wi-Fi connection. Otherwise, the Wi-Fi connection works well. But the folks at Zivix who make the JamStik said we could do better. So that's what they did. So let me disconnect from this device. And again, to disconnect, all I have to do is hit the I, and I can say forget this network. I can say forget. Also in the app itself, in JamStik Connect, I just got a warning. I can also disconnect from there as well. Now, this other device, and I'll power this one down, the JamStik Plus, on the other hand, boots up in a similar way and has the exact same layout. So it has the same button down here. It has the D-pad and has the power adapter there. But when I turn that on, again, you don't mess with going on top of the strings because it's an IR sensor, so it's sensing where your fingers are. JamStik Plus does not use JamStik Connect. It uses the JamStik Plus app. That looks like this. And what you do is you simply, once the JamStik is ready to go, the JamStik, I've got to turn on Bluetooth. Make sure that we've got Bluetooth turned on, which helps. And now you can see, maybe on the list at the bottom, one turned dark. And these other items that are grayed out are other Bluetooth MIDI devices that I own, such as the C24, the Puck from Zivix. But if I just select this, it's going to say connected and it's good to go. So there's no messing around with Wi-Fi, there's no dinking around with any of that, and now I have access to the internet while I'm using the app. And it's hard to see to hold it and play at the same time, but as I press down notes on the fretboard, you'll see how they light up in various positions. That's the infrared sensors doing their jobs. And part of a reason why the JamStik knows what you're doing. And that technology is the same from generation one to generation two. And then the only other difference is the sensitivity of the strings thanks to an extra electrical pickup right here at the bottom. So again, you have the option of different voices. It shows you what you're playing, what chords you have, if I'm playing a chord. And again, if I go into any other app at this point now, I can access Bluetooth MIDI. So if I'm working in Notion, this will transmit MIDI data from here into Notion or into any other core MIDI enabled app. And yep, it's, let's say I'm gonna choose 12 string acoustic like the other one. So just like the other JamStik, it does the same exact thing. And again, slightly improved again with the extra pickup and greatly improved with the Bluetooth MIDI. So it's fun to see a company that's come so far in less than a year, really. And part of the deal was that this device, the original one, was made before Apple released the Bluetooth MIDI standard. And Zivix was forced with trying to find a solution, and Wi-Fi was the best solution for low latency and everything else that they were doing. And that was true until iOS 8 came out last fall after this had been released. And then they immediately jumped to it with a Kickstarter campaign to make the JamStik Plus. This was an Indiegogo. This one is a Kickstarter campaign. And now you can buy this yourself from the Zivix website. Just go to jamstik.com. And it is, again, an improvement. Now, again, if you are, my iPad is in a message for low battery mode, so that's why it's not playing. So if you are a person that is a full-out guitarist and you're looking for a Bluetooth MIDI guitar that's the full guitar, this is not going to be it for you. It does have the ability to catch some of those things like pull-offs and hammer-ons, and I am not as much of a guitarist to deal with any of that. Where I deal with guitar is levels 1, 2, and 3 in the Hal Leonard books, as we teach beginning guitar players to both play guitar and read some music at the same time. And this device does more than I need for myself, and it does more than I need for my classroom. So they do hold up very well to classroom abuse. I have a set of JamSticks, about 9 of them, that I have at my school, and they have withstood the test of damage over that year, being dropped by 8th graders in that case. On the back also, there's a little spot where Zivix gives you a guitar strap with has a little click plug in it, and if you plug that in there and pull it to the side, it locks in. The only damage we saw on one of our original JamSticks at school was a student had the guitar strap in and dropped the JamStik about, you know, the distance of 3 feet or so onto our carpet-covered concrete in our choir room at my school. And the force of that ended up breaking this little piece a little bit so that the piece would no longer lock in for the guitar strap. Finding that a lot of students don't like to play with the guitar strap, even though really to get the true experience of playing, it should be suspended in a way just like a guitar, otherwise you find yourself doing cheats and things like that. In regards to the app, I use their app, JamStik Tutor, to teach with, and to my surprise, a lot of the students tried to find shortcuts. And early on with JamStik and JamTutor, they just simply tried to play all the notes at one time, especially with open string exercises, and the app was counting that as partially correct. But as they advanced as players, it became harder to do. Now, again, I even had some challenges. For example, there's some crazy kind of Guitar Hero-like games with JamStik Tutor, where it switches between an E chord and an A chord, and again, this is JamStik that's not connected. And I had a hard time with the original JamStik to get the program to sense when I was playing those chords. Even though when I played it on JamStik Connect, the chords sounded, it wasn't picking it up in the game. I've seen that already improved with the new pickup with the JamStik Plus. They are committed to bringing out more content. They've already shown JamStik Tutor 2 will be coming, because JamStik Tutor 1 doesn't take you that far. But trust me, if you're shooting for 3 stars and everything, you're gonna have to work sometimes to get it, maybe even if you're an accomplished musician. And again, my only qualm with JamStik Tutor is that it does not teach traditional note writing. It teaches you basically how to read tablature, and they have a new relationship with Hal Leonard. Hal Leonard is now a distributor for the JamStik, and I believe that there's going to be content shared back to JamStik to make with. So for example, wouldn't it be wonderful to see Hal Leonard Guitar Method or Essential Elements Guitar Method, which is almost the same exact thing, same author and everything else. Wouldn't it be great to see those books as a Guitar Hero-like interactive app, not only teaching tablature and how to play guitar, but also how to read some music at the same time, like actually notation. So great product. I definitely recommend it. The other thing that I didn't mention again is that it's always in tune. You can buy extra strings. I haven't seen a string break yet, and that's with 1 full year of use with students. You can buy extra strings, you can buy extra batteries. They sell those as a kit. So that's the JamStik Plus. I recommend it. If you were teaching Guitar Method and you had iOS devices, by the way, this will also work with an iPhone, which is kind of crazy to think about. But if you have iPads in your school that you could designate for your guitar class, it might not be too long before an investment like this paid off beyond a real guitar. Now, granted, you would eventually want to transition students to a regular guitar, and there's no reason why they couldn't be playing a regular guitar at the same time. But let's be honest, most of those students that sign up for your guitar class have a guitar at home that they can practice on, and they could have these at school to work with. Great idea, great way to gamify education, and I'm just excited to see the future. So, JamStik Plus, available from Zivix at jamstik.com.